The broadcast is now starting. All attendees are in listen-only mode.
Hey, what's going on, everybody? How you doing? I am absolutely thrilled to be here. It's Ryan here. I am very excited about today's webinar because it's not very often that I'm able to convince one of my high-level private clients to actually teach what they're doing. Now, just to give you a sense for what we're about to cover here today and why I'm so excited and why you should be so excited about this, you have to understand something. Based on the amount of money that I charge for someone to be able to hire and work with me privately, it means that their business is doing a certain volume, that they are at a certain success level. In other words, not everybody can get access. And the reason why our guest today, Dr. Harlan Kilstein, is able to work with me privately is because he has probably figured out the most, I don't say this lightly, but the most sophisticated yet drop-dead simple system for building a massive list using Facebook in a way that I have never seen anybody do it. And the reason why I'm so excited is because I've actually seen this play out behind the scenes. You have to understand, when clients work with me, they share things with me confidentially that I will never divulge publicly, but sometimes I literally have to bite my finger because it's so good. What Harlan is about to teach today is probably, if I had to start over from scratch and I had no assets, no system, nothing, and I needed to build a list from scratch, this is exactly the methodology that I would follow. I've had the benefit, fair advantage of seeing exactly how this works, and so I'm super excited for what Harlan's going to be teaching today. Harlan is operating in a really exciting space, the space that I wanted to get into for some time, and when he approached me and asked to work together, it was a happy day in my office because he's done some really amazing things, and he's going to show you what he's done, and he's going to show you how you can do it too. Now, I do want to be perfectly upfront. Harlan does have a program, a paid program, that teaches his entire intricate method in detail. However, he is going to be teaching on this webinar. So, in other words, this is going to be something that you can take notes on, you can walk away with a ton of actionable information, and then for people who want to go deeper, for people who want to really take this to the next level, then there's going to be an opportunity to do that at the end. With that said, Harlan, I'd love to turn over the controls to you and say a few words. I'm thrilled to be here, and I'm going to be taking some notes myself because every time that you and I get on the phone and every time that you and I talk, I end up learning something. And maybe you'll talk about one of the things that you've really added to my model, which was a massive eye-opener, which I had never done before, and I think you know what I'm talking about. And that's just a perfect example of the kind of guy you are. So, Harlan, my man, thrilled to have you here. Take it away, my friend.
All right. Well, hi, everybody. I am so pleased to be here. I would also like to personally thank Verizon MiFi for making this all possible today on a day when my internet Comcast has decided that the internet in my neighborhood should go out. My little Verizon MiFi here is ticking away, making all of this possible. So I would give it a big wet kiss, but it might be embarrassing. So folks, welcome. I'm going to be talking to you about the instant list method, the road to a huge list. But moreover, as Ryan said, there's going to be some serious content. There are people here of all levels on the call. I'm not sure of the levels. There are people here who are Facebook newbies in business and Facebook advertising. There are people here who are advanced. There are people here who are intermediate. So just so I know who's on the call, if you would be so kind as to type in newbie, intermediate, or I'm so super advanced, you should shut up and let me teach. Go ahead and type that in.
And as people are typing that in, if if I just want to make sure everybody can hear okay. I know Jess said that she was having some issues, that there was an audio glitch. Jim mentioned that his internet was giving him problems. If as you're typing in these answers, newbie, intermediate, if you could just kind of give me a little bit. Okay, Hassan says can hear just fine. Yeah, sounds good, says Mark. Okay, awesome. Awesome. So if just a little bit of confirmation, make sure the audio is good. Take it away, my man.
All right. So tell me what we're seeing here.
So I'm looking at this right now, and I'll just go through kind of the list. I love this because I recognize most of the names here on the list, which is awesome. So I'm going to start at the beginning. Jess has rebooted webinar. Lorraine says newbie. Ken says good here. Okay, Ann says newbie. Pierre says new. Wendy says advanced. Josh says looking to learn more, so he hedged his bets. Kosio, and Kosio, forgive me if I mispronounce your name. Sounds good. Richard Denzer says low to intermediate. Marcel says newbie, shut up and teach, smiley face. Arlene says fairly new. Bernard is intermediate. Judy says newbie. Alex says newbie. Yeah, we're going to do GoToWebinar comments on this because the reason why I bring that up, when we do this training webinars for Next Level Mastermind members only, we do the chat in Facebook. So if someone's in Facebook right now in the group, we're going to do chat comments in GoToWebinar since there's some people who are not members of the program on this training. Ron says advanced. Adam says newbie. Kent says professional wannabe. Chris says newbie, intermediate, super advanced, but willing to learn. Jackie says fairly new, intermediate, advanced from Michael. Gary says intermediate. Jason says he built Facebook. You laugh, but I'm friends, good friends with Noah Kagan, and he was like employee number 11 or whatever, 30 at Facebook, so he can actually legitimately say that. Experience, Jess's experience, advanced, but that's up for question on this webby. Says Darren, medium, pretty much newbie, intermediate. So, you know, it's truly a mix. And then Vernon wraps up, says educate me. Truly a mix. I would say if I were to ballpark it, it's probably the most that I'm seeing is intermediate with a few advanced and definitely some newbies as well.
Okay, fantastic. That gives me an idea. Thank you so much. It is my goal that everybody learn something here. And I truly appreciate the people who say they're advanced, but learn something more. I happen to see one of the people on the line and stood up as someone who was like the king, in my mind, of Facebook engagement and selling on Facebook, who is just here humbly hiding and saying that they're here to learn more. So let's go ahead and jump in. Always begin with a legal disclaimer that, again, there are, I don't believe in get-rich schemes. I believe in hard work, and nothing promises you that you're going to make $1 million here by tomorrow morning. It might take you at least until next Monday. Seriously, folks, there are no get-rich-quick schemes. So who am I? Ryan is one of his clients. Many people consider me one of the top marketing consultants in the world. My students have 9-figure businesses. My typical client, someone who would hire me, makes in excess of $1 million a month. And people consider me an A-list copywriter. People that I've written for, Rich Sheffrin, I wrote his manifesto many years ago in the sales letters for his first launch. Frank Kern, I've written for him 3 or 4 times. Jay Abraham, I wrote for him a bunch of times. John Calton, I ghosted for him once or twice. Wayne Dyer, the self-help guru. I write periodically for Mind Valley, and I coach their top copywriter. People like Alex Mandozian, Perry Marshall, and so many more names that I've probably forgotten. And you see me with the old Frank Kern before his the haircut and the suit way back in the mass control days. And I know a little bit about Facebook, too. 3 years ago, I started a site on dogs. And those were the days when it was fashionable to go after a particular breed. I decided that I was going to go after not the entire a particular breed, but after dogs in general. I created a site called the Doggington Post, and in 3 years, it has become the leader, dominant authority in the industry. We are quoted all of the times, on sites like CNN, the BBC. We're just quoted by the Huffington Post. So we get around, and our reach on Facebook, until Facebook started killing reach, was we reached as many as you see here, 40 million in a particular week. Now, this is all organic, so we're pretty good at driving organic traffic. We get anywhere from 750,000 to 1 million page views a month on our site. It comes from Facebook. It comes from organic. We do no SEO on the site at all, and still, if there's a keyword that we want to rank for, we'll be on the first page of Google, typically in about 10 to 20 minutes without doing any SEO at all. I've been called on that by SEO experts, and they've looked at my site and they say, yeah, well, how did all these links come? And I say, I wouldn't even know how to build a link. So some of my credentials in the dog world, the challenge. One of the challenge is, especially with Facebook, is that Facebook changes direction more often than a teenage girl decides what boyfriend she likes this week. What Facebook says are the rules this week, Facebook changes next week. And you have to stay on top of the rules, because it's like Animal House with double secret probation. They don't tell you the rules have changed until it's too late. And now what I'd like to do is I'd like to challenge you to find out if you'd like to rapidly build a huge list. Because if that's something that's interesting you, then you're in the right place. If you're a Facebook expert, you're going to possibly learn some stuff today. We're going to be talking about the newest changes in Facebook, Facebook's newest announcements. I'd like to bring you up to date on that as well. So what I encourage you to do is there's a saying that seeing is believing, and I'd like to encourage you to believe that the reverse is also true, is that belief is seeing. So let's jump in and see what we can see. Now, there's one thing that I'm known for, and Ryan kind of politely hinted at it in one of the emails or one of the posts, and that is I've been known to have a big mouth. Ryan, would you agree with that?
The subject line on my original email that I was going to send out to my list, just to give you a sense, is my most prickly private client.
That's such an honor. It's such an honor. Someone here described me as a salmon swimming upstream, like the entire internet is swimming in one direction, and there have been many, many times that I've called people out on their stuff, and it's not politically correct. It is absolutely not politically correct, and I get a lot of heat over it. But my fans love me, and my detractors don't love me anyway, so what the hell? Now, one of the things that get me is when people say that you can't make money on Facebook. And I have to tell you that I think that that is a load of bunk. It's just people who don't know what they're doing. I want to share with you something that many of you have probably heard of, It's from my old teacher and friend, Gary Halbert. Gary used to call me at like 3 in the morning and talk copy with me. And he was just this unbelievably gifted copywriter. And gosh, he had an unusual personality. So Gary's teaching, or probably most famous teaching, was the teaching of the hamburger stand and determining which hamburger stand would sell the most. Now, Gary's boys, Bond and Kevin, have reissued a lot of Gary's newsletters with some famous copywriters reading them. And this letter, you get to choose the letter you want to read. And this letter was chosen by Gary Bensavenga, who is arguably one of the greatest copywriters today. He's mostly retired, doesn't write for the big newsletter companies anymore, works only for himself in the olive oil business. And Gary read a letter where Gary Halbert asks about what would make the most successful hamburger. Gary would talk about how he would teach this in a webinar, and people would say, location, location, location. And some people would say, you need the best recipe. You need a secret recipe like the Colonel. And other people would say, oh, be near a beach. Be near a sporting event. Be near a crowded mall where people wait for a bus. Have the best quality meat. And Gary would sit there and listen to everything that came in, and finally he'd say, I would give you all of those things, and I would still beat you. How many people know the answer to this? Go ahead. If you know the answer, type it in.
Well, I know the answer because I'm a long-term student of Sir Gary Halbert.
But all right.
Let's see what some of the guesses that have coming through. Okay, so I'm not going to give away the right answer because I know what it is, but we'll just say.
Well, they're all getting the right answer.
Most people are, yeah, pretty much everyone's getting the right answer.
All right, and so it shows that this teaching, which is an absolutely crucial teaching, is the answer is a starving crowd.
Yep.
And so it's important that, as I'm going to show you in a couple of minutes, Facebook will build a list for you. But there's a difference between having a list and having a starving crowd. The kind of list that we are talking about today is building a starving crowd. So the order that no one talks about in success, as a copywriter, I love hearing people say, oh, it's copy, 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 copy. But the truth of the matter is, in test after test, the answer is the most important thing is your list, the next most important thing is your offer, and finally, the third most important thing is your copy. And so the right list will make you the most money. You could have the best copy in the world, but if it goes to the wrong, not going to make a dime. And that's something, this order is something that, if you didn't know, memorize this, because list, offer, copy has been tested again and again and again. So everybody, this group, I'm not even going to wait for an answer. When you finish the sentence, the money is in the list, okay? If you have a list, you have, and you have a good list, you have a buyer's list, you have a targeted list, you have the potential to make a lot of money. On the other hand, there are a lot of people who get started and can't get a list going. Now, Ryan, in our conversations, you told me that one of the biggest problems that you have with people following your teachings is that they can't get their deep dives survey done. Would I be correct in assuming that virtually everybody here has heard the term deep dive survey?
I'd say most people have heard, anybody who's gone through the SurveyFunnel formula training or has been on one of those webinars has heard me talk about the deep dive survey process, and you're absolutely right. People who have existing businesses, it's a slam dunk, easy thing to do, and by existing business, I'm talking about they have an existing list. But for the folks that stumble, it's usually because the question is, I don't have an audience to survey, what do I do?
Okay, now do you recall how quickly I built my list?
It was pretty quick. It was you tell me, I don't want to misquote, but I know it's pretty quick.
I believe it was, what, a day or two?
When we did our survey, the deep dive?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Like, oh, I thought you were talking about your entire list. Yeah, when we did the deep dive survey, we hashed it out and we got it live, and I think you Facebook messaged me like later that day and you said, here's the data, what do we do with it?
Right. And the reason is because I had an exceptional responsive list and we had the data pretty darn quickly. Okay? And that's the kind of thing that, you know, that I want you to have. Now, list building over the ages, unfortunately, hasn't changed all that much. Okay, in the old days, when people were just getting started, it was opt in and we'll send you email. And everybody went, oh boy, I'm going to get email. Then it changed opt in and we'll send you a special report. And the special report was a very poorly disguised sales letter. Opt in and we'll try and sell you something is what it really should have said. Opt in and we'll send you discount coupons. That actually works today. Opt in, we'll send you free videos. Hopefully your language will be a little bit better, but that works as well. And the one that doesn't work real well is the one that says, please, I'm begging you to opt in. I'm really a nice guy. Friends and family like me, you probably will too. So list building hasn't changed all that much. Now, sometimes you just can't get people to opt in. Now, in the Facebook group last night, I happened to see a post, and I don't know if the person's on the call or not. I'll be gentle. But the person had a difficulty in getting people to opt in.
And just to clarify, when Harlan is talking about the Facebook group, for those who aren't familiar, he's talking about our, because Harlan is a member of the group as well, our paid Next Level Mastermind Facebook group, if anybody who's not part of that, just to provide that.
If you're not part of that, you seriously should need to check your pulse, okay? It's probably the hottest group on Facebook, and I how you got all of that talent in that group, but there's some pretty amazing people in that group.
Cool.
And that's a credit to you, sir.
Well, I didn't want to derail you, but I just want to provide that context so people know when we say Facebook group what we're referring to.
Okay.
So carry on. So we saw a page, and this is the page that we were looking at. Basically, a member of the group presented a landing page and said, I can't get people to opt in. Can you help? And I think probably, 50, 60, 70 comments of feedback on the page.
I mean, people who are experts in the industries, one of your clients who is currently dominating the weight loss niche, was one of the people who was kind enough to opt in. And it's humbling to it's humbling to have that that situation when they're just all these all stars, and it's just crazy. So hold on one second.
And so as you're looking at this page and Harlan's catching his breath, take a look, and even in the chat, I would love to just be curious to know, especially anyone who hasn't been exposed to this before, What are, and I don't want to steal any of your thunder, Harlan, if you were planning on doing this, it's not rehearsed or anything. I'm just curious to know, what do you see as the errors, right? Just looking at this page, knowing what you know about conversion, what is this page missing? What's on this page that you don't think should be on this page? What issues do you see? What gaps? What holes? I'm just really curious to know. I'd love, in the chat, go for it. I'd love to see, and I'll kind of rattle off some of the things that people, Toby says they saw the discussion, Marcel saying no offer at all. Bill offers extremely specific advice and says the page.
Hey, that's my line.
He's just quoting. Awesome.
If I did that, I'd be in trouble.
I told Harlan he has to be gentle because Harlan has a mannerism about him where he likes to tell it how it is, and I know not everybody has a thick enough skin to handle that type of direct feedback. So I asked him to play gentle. So keep going, my man.
Okay. So here the problem is this person put up a page, and they want to get people to opt into a webinar. And, you know, people were all over them. They didn't like the background picture of, you know, like the three bodies. It didn't look like real people. They said the before and afters. If you look at the middle before and after, it looks like they have no resemblance at all. Same thing with the one on the right, you know, in other words. Just no proof that those are the people. Actually, when we saw it the first time, the person who put this up had their themselves in the middle of it. You couldn't understand what was going on. What I want to point out to you here, and we're going to come back to this, is that they're coming from Facebook. Their goal is to build a list. Their goal is to get people onto a webinar. Their goal is to sell them. And their opt-in rate has been absolutely zero. And one of the things, I actually sent Ryan a message today going, well, gee, Ryan, you know, you are the survey funnel guy. Why isn't this person doing a survey? For example, here's my Just 4 Minutes site. And when someone comes from Facebook to my page, they come to a survey. I don't have to persuade them to do anything. I ask them some very, very basic questions. Abs. I know that exercise speeds up my fat burning. I often don't have enough time in the day to exercise. Even though exercise is important, sometimes it's boring. They take about 10 questions, and then they're asked to give me their email address. And I was just quite frankly surprised that not enough people were doing surveys. People love surveys. They love games, especially from Facebook. You know, you can take all of these games, you know, I don't know if you know it, but like when Ryan's on the phone and he's supposed to be paying attention to clients, he's really taking tests like, what dinosaur are you? And those like Tyrannosaurus Rex or something like that.
Market research.
Research. So market research. The bottom line is, if you want to come from Facebook and you want to get a list, well, if I were doing this today, I would certainly bring them to a simple survey. So the first takeaway is, if you want to build the list off Facebook, use surveys in place of opt-ins. Okay? Go ahead and do that. Now, when you build an email list, people are going to join your email list. 4% of them will buy something in the near future. I don't know if you know his name. I refer to him as Dr. Dean Jackson. I know we've talked about him. I consider him one of the smartest people on the internet. And he's actually calculated that a relatively small people will buy something within 30 to 60 days of joining your list. But today, a huge percent of your emails will just not be delivered. I was working out at my gym this morning, and my torturer, also known as my personal trainer, said, hey, Harlan, what did you think of the email I sent? And I went and I found it in my spam folder. And there was nothing in there that should have been considered a spam. Huge percent of your emails never get to the inbox. charges from list companies continue to explode. I remember when I paid hard for my AWeber list, and now I'm over $1,000 a month, $12,000 a year, God bless them, for a service that barely delivers my emails. You're paying for people who don't open your emails ever. You're paying for people who have undeliverable emails. You're paying for people who unsubscribe to your emails. But everybody knows the bigger your list, the more money you make. And what I'm challenging today is that whether or not purely an email list is the best way for you to go. And that may not be the case. Now, when Frank Kern made his famed first $1 million a year in the dog market, the question, his open rate was less than 0.5%. So, Ryan, you're the math guy. I mean, what kind of numbers did he need to have on that list to do that kind of money? I think the product was like either $27 or $37, and there was no upsell. Crazy.
Yeah,
huh?
I mean, if you're getting a 1% open rate, you've got to have a pretty big list. You know, maybe 10% of his list actually bought something, which is like a fair. I'm in a bunch of different markets, and that number varies widely, Harlan, as you know, but 10% is kind of a good starting point. 10% of your email list will buy something. You might do wildly better than that, but in a mass market like that, that's probably fair. So, you know, backing into that number, we would do, what's that, 0.1 point divided by just 0.0. I might have this wrong. Point divided by 0.1.
Well, your math is going to be better than mine. I came up with the number 26.
That's awesome. Let's see, one, three, keep going. I'll do the math in the back and I'll come up with
the
number.
You know, now it gets worse. The Google slaps were largely centered around squeeze pages. And there are still people today who don't understand that Google does not love squeeze pages. And Facebook is really wishy-washy about them too. We're seeing lots of pages being banned because people are using lead pages. Now, I have nothing against lead pages or any of the other things, but in a lot of them, Facebook is banning them, and a lot of Facebook experts are noting this, that if you take your lead page and, you know, you put it up on your site and use your own domain name, the same page is approved. Do I have an explanation for that? No, other than just be flexible and respect what Facebook says. When you have these email lists, chances are you have a really good chance that your email will not go to an inbox. Only a fraction of your emails will ever be opened. Only a tiny fraction of those emails will ever be read. A smaller fraction will click on the links. A smaller fraction will buy something. And according to Dean, your real sales come in after 18 months of mailing someone to get them to buy. Right? Have you ever heard Dean's explanation of that?
I haven't, no.
Okay, but a very small percent comes in, and what he does is, this is something really cool, another hint stolen from Dean Jackson, is that when you sign up for a list, when you're building your list, you have the option of having the email company notify you that you have a list, that someone has signed up for your list. Now, most people don't turn those notifications on. What Dean does is he creates a dummy email account on Gmail, sends those notifications there, and when someone buys, he checks to see how long ago they opted in. So he's really tracking those percents, and he's found 18 months of mailing someone is typical to get them to buy. That shows a heck of a lot of persistence on the part of the marketer to develop it. Personally, I'd like my money a lot faster. Plus, contrary to report, emails are not free. If you build a big enough list and your email fees can go into the thousands or tens of thousands every month. Sometimes having a really big list is a curse. I was once hired to do marketing for someone who had a gun list. And his gun list was, as I recall, 5 million strong. And they had me write emails for them, and you know, I wrote the emails. And then they said to me, okay, we're going to send them. And I said, how are you going to send them? What email service are we in? Oh, we're not. We're sending them through our ISP. And I just laughed. They said, what's so funny? I said, your ISP is not going to let you send 5 million emails. They said, why not? And they said, call them. And they called them, and sure as shooting, they would not, because they couldn't verify that, you know, they had the rights. They couldn't prove the days that these people opted in. These were actually customers, and they didn't have all of that data on the days that they were opted in. They had to get a special emailer, and they could mail 100,000 at a time. And I just like shook my head, and I said, you know, my emails are never going to be delivered. And mailing 100,000 at a time, you have a 5 million list. You think you can mail? How much time does it take to mail if you were going to have a Black Friday special? But most of those emails went directly to the spam filter. So grow a big list. If you don't know what you're doing, the big list is totally unusable for you. Now, let's change directions. Business Week this July said that Americans spend 40 minutes a day minimum on Facebook. That's 4 hours a week. Just a quick question, guys. Let me know how much that you spend 40 minutes a day. 40 minutes a day.
For me, it's sort of like the embarrassing question, do you read the National Enquirer? I feel like this is one of these things that we have to do a reverse discount on whatever answer people say, because it's not something that I'm proud to admit, but the answer is, especially with our private Facebook group, I certainly spend more than 40 minutes a day on Facebook. It's not all at once, but over the course of the day, I'm a power user, I guess you could say. So.
Okay. So some people are saying I spend much more. Some people are saying I don't spend that a week. But here's Business Week saying that that's what's happening. So let's say you want to build a Facebook page, okay? We're going to build a Facebook page about our new business. Well, ever since May, Facebook has been killing organic reach. 1 week, our organic reach was, what was it, 40 million. And then the next week, it was 25 million. And the next week, it was 15 million. And then 10 million. And then 8 million. And then 5 million. And now we're in between 1.5 million and 2 million a week. It changes from day to day. And I meet with Facebook a lot and talk to them. And I said, you know, could you explain my organic reach going down? Now, I knew that they had killed organic reach. I just wanted to hear what they said. And they just smiled at me and said, yes, Harlan, we've lowered the organic reach on pages. And they gave me their reason that they wanted to make sure that the timeline, each person's timeline, is pristine. So Facebook has been steadily killing organic reach. And when you point it out to people who go ahead and look at it and they go, oh, yeah. And the reason is that simply they want you to buy ads to sell things, and they want you to buy ads to promote your content. So Facebook said, look, we've got to justify ourselves to our people on Wall Street, so it's all about the ads. Now, we've tested all the things I'm talking about. We have tested out the wazoo. And you get more bang for your buck for keeping people on Facebook. And in keeping people on Facebook, bringing people to a story on Facebook, a video on Facebook, you have the same video uploaded to your page, you will get much more engagement. Take those same people to the same video on YouTube, and your reach goes way, way down. Why is that? It's because of Facebook's engagement formula. They want to keep people on Facebook. The ultimate goal is that they want people to open Facebook in the beginning of the day and just leave it open the entire day, bringing things such as chat and everything to mobile. They want you to be dominated by Facebook, because there's another, and I'll say evil reason, is when Facebook is open, they get to follow you around the internet. They learn about you, and the data, as we're going to see really shortly, is just amazing what they know about you. Facebook absolutely clamps down on external links. Take people off Facebook, and you don't get the same thing. Now, we're still getting our three-quarters of a million page views to a million page view a month. That's with it clamped down. If Facebook took the governor off the engine, we'd probably be at 3 million page views a month. Now, external links still work if you have a compelling headline. You can definitely get lots of people over to your page if you have a compelling headline. The way to write a compelling headline is to really know your niche, know your avatar, and know what things get them excited, what things get their juices flowing. You can get them to your site. For a long time, sites like Viral Nova were using clickbait headlines. And everybody waited to hear what Ryan Levesque was going to say. And at 12:13, they were shocked to hear, you know, whatever.
Those are the worst. You know, it's like boy climbs up side of roof, and what happened next will shock you. I mean, everything. It's like, you know, child sits down to eat breakfast. What happened next will shock you.
and man
tied left shoe before right shoe. What happened next will shock you.
And they worked so well that Viral Nova, that built its site and able to come along and do these things, were making just tens and tens of thousands of dollars on AdSense by bringing people to this page. Absolutely crazy what they were doing. Okay, so Facebook said, all right, game's over. If you use clickbait headlines, we're going to begin phasing them out. Continue to use them, and your website is going to get very, very lonely. And every single one of those sites that uses, if you look Alexa to track traffic, every single one of those sites, from Upworthy to Viral Nova, that use those headlines, has seen them go down. And unfortunately, people who want to use Facebook as a selling tool have discovered that by the headline. And Facebook has just announced this week, ultra new, is that there's no more free ride. So, for example, I have this, you know, wonderful page all about dogs. I have another page all about meditation. I have all of these fantastic pages, and we post a link, and it's an affiliate thing or to one of our products. Great, great, great. And now Facebook has said, you want to reach your own, you want to reach your own people, your own clients that you bought, you know, you got links or you grew organically or whatever. You now have to pay to reach those people. So if you built a page and you want to now capitalize, it's time to cash in, Facebook just held out its hand and said, you know, cross my palm with a coin, or no one is going to see it. Now, fortunately, first of all, number one, Facebook is phasing this in. Facebook is phasing this in and you now have you have until January. So you can capitalize on Black Friday, Cyber Monday, Super Saturday, and all the days in between. Okay, that's super important for you to know about. Okay, so the free ride, Facebook will know if you are doing something that is, they called it promotional or selling. Facebook will know, and Facebook will squish your engagement like a dead bug unless you pay for it. So Facebook is now moving for marketers pretty much that pretty much to a system where you're paying for reach. No more free ride. And so then there's a question. Why should you build a page? All right. Ryan Levesque wants to build a page called Survey Funnel, and he'd like to make some money off of it. I mean, 90% of what Ryan does is charitable, right? and he would like to reach it. So, Ryan, why build the page at all? Why even bother? And the answer is because you are building trust. And because you are building a brand. All those people who were selling Amazon products, and God bless them, FBA, Amazon, make $1 million a month on Amazon, and you know, I love them all, but they discovered that when there's competition on Amazon, people were reaching for the brands. It's all online. It's all about trust, and brands get trust. So when you have a Facebook page, you are building trust, and if you give value, value will lead to fans. The purpose of your Facebook page has changed. It is no longer you can use your page to advertise. You can use your page to build credibility, and then when you advertise from your page and people associate that advertising with you, it will go over twice as much. The other thing is we call this the thinning of the herd. Many of the people are going to be gone. Facebook has certain ways where they want things done. I saw someone post in another group today that they were on the phone with reach out to us and we'll try and help you. And Facebook asked permission to like go into your account, even though they really have the right to do so. They went into this person's account with them and they saw that they had something like 50 or 60 Facebook pages that weren't being used. And they said, okay, you don't need those. And they right away like took away 15 or 30 of them. And the person was outraged. Those are my pages. No, they're Facebook's pages, and you get to play by Facebook's rules or take your ball and bat and go home. So I'm a big believer in playing by Facebook's rules, and everything that I do on Facebook, since I speak to them so often, I run by them to make sure that is 100% legal beagle. So on Facebook, the statistic that you need to keep in mind is not engagement, not reach. I know a lot of people who make themselves absolutely crazy on that. The only thing that you should care about is what's your ROI, what's your return on investment. That's the only thing that matters. If you can consistently give Facebook a dollar and they'll give you $2, $4, in some cases I had $22 back, you want to keep spending money on Facebook. That's the thing you track. Yes, you can track other things as well, but the real big one is what's your ROI. Now, what people don't tell you because they absolutely don't know is, yes, you can advertise from your Facebook page, and now you have a lot more credibility if you deliver really good content. You have this added trust. You get your ROI. The truth of the matter is you don't even need content on the page if you're advertising regularly. I proved that this summer when in a mood of funk when someone said, Harlan, you can't advertise unless you have some serious content. I built a page called Nothing. And this page was about absolutely nothing. When you go to the page, there's a big empty sky and said, this page is about nothing. And people got into it, and the comments on the page were hilarious. You know, we would post songs that mentioned the word nothing, emptiness, and whatever. And everyone had a grand old time, and I rapidly developed a huge list there of people who were interested in nothing. Now, I didn't try to monetize it, but my point is you can get people to like anything on Facebook, even nothing at all. The key is targeting. Now, some of the biggest courses that I've seen don't even mention targeting. They just leave it entirely out. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at what Facebook will do for you. Okay? Everybody stick with me. Some of you can say, yeah, I know this. I'm going to give you a little spin on it that may be a little bit different than what you're doing. Now, everybody has on Facebook what is a suggested friends list. You might be a match with these people. Some of these people went to high school with you a bunch of years ago. Some of these people might be your next door neighbors. Some of these people might be someone that you met a long time ago and you forgot. Some of these people might be competitors in business. Some of these people might be people that Facebook suggests if your status is both single that you might want to get to know a little bit better. Facebook plays Yentl the matchmaker, like from Fiddler on the Roof. The accuracy of this thing, of these suggested friends, is insane because it's based on a formula that there are, and it varies, from a low of 150 to a high of 1,000 points of commonality. In other words, when you look at this person they're suggesting to you, there's a darn good reason. And sometimes I moved in February down the block. As soon as we got the internet turned on, Facebook was suggesting my neighbors as new suggested friends. They were able to tell from my IP address where I was now, and they suggested the neighbors across the street and next door to me, like I might want to be friends with them on Facebook. So the bottom line is this thing is crazy, crazy accurate. Now, you can also upload your email lists. If you have a list of buyers, you can upload your email list, and Facebook will build a list for you based on their algorithm of 150 points of commonality. And when they do this, if you upload your buyers list, that's called creating a lookalike audience based on your buyers. Facebook will overnight, and now it's even faster, build an audience for you. Typically, the audience that they build is in the millions. Now, Facebook, if you do this, Facebook gives you a choice, either size or accuracy. And I suggest that you always go for accuracy. Now, I know that your friend Kurt Malley has been on and has taught, and Kurt has actually played with size as the thing. He's like gone both ways, and he's done size. If you're interested in ROI, I'm always going to recommend that you choose accuracy. He's complained that even their size list does well. It depends what you're selling. Actually, if I was selling a weight loss product, then maybe size would matter. But typically, I have some pinpointed things that I'm looking for. I always recommend and I always choose accuracy. So this is called a lookalike audience, and you can target these people, and you can do whatever you would want to do with them through Facebook advertising. You can have as many lookalike audiences as you want, and Facebook makes it very, very easy for you. And they strongly encourage you to, if you want to talk to Facebook, go in and play with their audience insights and create a lookalike audience all of a sudden there will be appear a button up at the top saying, hey, would you like some help with your with creating a audiences on Facebook? And a Facebook rep will be very happy to speak to you and walk you through it. You can also create lookalike audiences based on your fan page. And the nice thing about this is that you can create them based on particular countries. So my list is so big, well, I might want a list of fans for the Doggington Post in Canada. I might want a list of fans for the Doggington Post in the United States. I might want a list of fans of the Doggington Post in the United Kingdom. I might want to build a page like this for people in China where they would look at the dog site and think that it was really a restaurant. Did I say that? Sorry. Okay, so you can layer these audiences as well. And I'm going to show you what I'm talking about in just a moment. We're going to go live, and I'm going to demonstrate something, and then we're actually going to turn to you guys about building a list. And the information that Facebook is going to give you is just scary. Okay? Any copywriter knows that the first thing that you got to do is you got to know who's your avatar. What's your list all about? And this is what now Facebook makes it so darn easy for you. So we're going to go in and we're going to go live and we're going to look at audience insights. So let's go over to Facebook. And when you go into your advertising account, the first thing that you're going to see is that it offers you everyone on Facebook, people connected to your page, or a custom audience. Well, we're going to go to everyone on Facebook. Okay? And now this is literally everybody on Facebook, and we get insight into their behavior, okay? Insight into their behavior. Now, the currency on Facebook is called the like, okay? So I want to find out about a niche. Stay with me here because this is killer information. This is going to save you a lot of money. Okay, so our thing that we want is people who like golf, okay? And now we see, Ryan, can you see that?
I see it.
Okay, Ryan, what are the demographics here according to Facebook?
Interestingly, it looks like 55% men, 45% women.
Now, you have someone who's in the golf niche, is that correct?
Yes, and I do need to be very careful.
We aren't giving them away.
Ask me whatever question you want. I'll be perfectly honest if I can answer, because I have access to, obviously, confidential proprietary information, but
okay.
Go for it.
Well, we're going to see the answer in just a second.
Well, anything that's on Facebook is fine, yeah.
Okay. Would you say, does your client's list resemble what Facebook says?
I will say categorically no.
Okay. Now let's see why. Because golf is a pretty useless indicator of who the golfer is. So now, for example, if I go, okay, what pages do they like? Facebook's going to tell me that they like making birdies, they like Tiger Woods, Cam Newton, they like the Auburn Tigers, the Dark Blue Devil Athletics, the Minnesota Gophers. And they like things like TaylorMade Golf, Oakley's, Bass Pro Shops. Now, Bass Pro Shops is not known for its golf collection, mm-hmm. Okay? We'll even see how much money they have. But as I've told you, this is pretty bogus information. So let's come back here. Let's get rid of golf. And now we're going to put in some golf products. So one of them is TaylorMade Golf, TaylorMade Adidas. Okay. Look what happened to those demographics. Can you read them now?
Interesting.
All right.
86% men, 14% women.
Is that a little closer to your clients?
Getting there.
Now, what if we put in Callaway?
Did I lose you? Oh.
No, I'm just pausing. Callaway Golf. All right, it's not letting me do that. How about Ping Golf?
Yeah, there we go.
Okay. Now all of a sudden, we see that the numbers before were totally bogus. So what I do at this point is I switch over and say, okay, now our market is men. Goodbye, women. We're not interested in you anymore. And we're going to start paying attention to them from age 25, and we're going to go up to 64. Even though typically I know the golf market, it's higher than that, but we're going to go after 25 to 64. Now, I can add more golf products here. There's a name of a store. I think it's called Golf Smith.
Yep.
Them in there. And again, we've got 500 to 600,000 monthly active people.
Right.
Now, who do they like? Everything on target for golf.
Yep.
Everything on target for golf. And we see who they really like. And we can get more and more. I spelled Callaway wrong. That's why.
Okay. Yep.
But I could add them as well. I can go and look at their incomes. I can look at how they buy. These people have huge amounts of money, way over the norm, huge percent. If we add those up, 19 and 11 is 30%. So we have 46% of the people are making more than 75 grand a year.
You know, what's interesting about this is just point out some of this stuff is what you'd expect, but then there's some stuff here. The reason why I love going through these exercises, Harlan, is because you always find something that's counterintuitive. If you scroll up, take a look at the home ownership. Is that what you would have expected?
No, I would not. I would expect there would be more. But
right.
When you look at these people, compared in other things and areas, I'm not finding that home ownership is jiving with what I would expect.
Mm-hmm.
I would expect these people would be higher in home ownership and less in rental.
Mm-hmm.
Unless these people, you know, they're recording a second home as
right.
a home as well.
Right.
Like these people have homes in Augusta or in Florida where they come down to play. All right. Now you can save this audience up here. You can create an ad. Whoops. You can create an ad and target these people that you single out. So the key thing here is that likes mean nothing. It's a bad list.
Mm-hmm.
And if you want to do a survey and you want to build a list, you want to target passionate people. Let's start all over again. Don't save this. Everyone on Facebook, let's go after people who like dogs. And it's humongous, 35 to 40 million. And let's look at our demographics. And our demographics are 66% women, 34% men. Do you remember the survey that we did together?
We're not quite there. We're not quite at an accurate split.
Nope, not at all. So what we want to do is we want to get rid of dogs, and we're going to go after some different things. Like how about Merrick Pet Food, Merrick Pet Care? How about Halo Pets? Okay. We're up to 300, 350K. Now, these things that I've chosen are some pretty good brands. We could put in the raw food. Let's do Stella Chewy's. That's raw dog food. All right. We've got the numbers remain the same. So 81% women, 19% men. We go over to the women. And now we see that the numbers really start to go up at age 35. So we go to women, age 35 and up. What are these people interested in? And we find out, so for example, if I were to have a page, they are really interested. Well, first of all, I see that they're interested in menopause. They're interested in insurance for their dogs. In other words, it says what? Notice that it says pet insurance. It doesn't say human insurance. It doesn't say Allstate. Yep. Okay. And you see the products that they like. What other pages do they like? What are they interested in? This is how you get information about your audience. And you see, now you can even target only credit card spenders. You can target people who have actually purchased something in the dog niche. But my takeaway for you here is you should be targeting buyers. So, Ryan, do you have anybody in the skin diving, scuba diving niche?
No, we can talk about that at will.
All right, here we go. Will, I don't think Will is in that niche.
No, Will's in a different niche. We can talk about this market at will, and I can hold nothing back.
Okay, so skin diving. Okay, that's got the wrong word. Let's go to stuff. Come on. Scuba diving.
Self-contained underwater breathing apparatus diving.
Okay, so the key is calling it scuba diving. We've got 2.5 to 3 million people a month. What are our demographics? 47% women, 54% men. And we're from 18 and up. What do these people like? They like, their favorite magazine is Diving Wrecks and Reefs. They're interested in scuba diver girls. Now here is, this is the kind of thing that I like. Divers Direct. Direct is a store that sells scuba gear. There is nobody in the world who likes Divers Direct unless they are buyers. Mm-hmm. Okay? And we see what they are interested in here.
That's a big one. I know you threw that in there, but that's an important point, right? If I like a hobby site, for example, that has information that tells me, that says nothing around whether or not I've spent money on that. I could just be a freebie seeker. But if I like an actual retail store, it's one of two things. I've either shopped there or I've bought something there. And even if I haven't bought something, I'm so much closer to a transaction than if I like an information site, right? If I like ESPN.com, I just probably read the free articles. But if I like Dick's Sporting Goods, it's because I went to Dick's to buy something.
Okay. So this is super, super. So we're going to take away scuba dive. Before we do it, we're going to go to Divers Direct. Now we have an audience that went from the millions to 40 to 45K. Ryan, quick challenge. Which would you rather have, an audience of 2 million people who like scuba diving or an audience of 45,000 people who like Divers Direct?
45,000 people, not even close for me.
Okay. And that's a huge takeaway, guys, is you want to be where the money is. Okay, now let's go back and see who these people are. Look what happened to our demographics. We went from fairly equal men and women, and we find out that the buyers in the industry are pretty solid. It is men, and they get started at 5, and they stop at 54. There's a huge jump after that. Huge dive down, excuse my French there. And that's who they are. Now we only have 20 to 25K, but these are the most passionate buyers. What are they like? You see exactly who they are, what they're doing. Facebook cut down on the data because this is so precise. If you want to make money on Facebook, the money is in not only the list, the money is in the highly targeted list. Okay? Is anybody here learning anything from this? And can you think about how to turn this to your own use? Are you learning something? Yes, no. When's the party start?
Mike says, woo woo. Deborah smiles. Deborah says, can I just say this is an incredibly valuable bringing Harlan to us? Getting a few specific questions, if you can, I don't want to derail where we're going, but just on the very tactical things, what we're talking about right now, do people have an interest in all of those or at least one? So all of the above or at least one as far as the addition.
Typically, it's not all of the above, but it's at least one. So you're getting an idea of these 20 to 25,000 as a group. We can come over here. We can see that where the money is. Look at that, 75% credit cards. That's a sign of a really good niche. Now, if I come here and I want to start all over again, and I want to go to, and this is really important, I want to go to Purina Dog Chow.
And the way you're coming up with these, this question that's come up in the chat, so I'm just trying to address it, the way that you've come up with these based on, what's the psychology behind it? Are these just brands of products that you're...
These are brands, and typically, logically, you're not going to like Purina Dog Chow unless you feed it to your dog.
Right, right.
Okay? So if I want to target this nearly a million people a month, right from the start, we see this thing that it's 77% women. These are the people who are shopping for Purina, and maybe they're going there expecting a coupon or something like that. But we see here the niche really starts at age 35 and goes to 64. And they're women. And what are they interested in? They're all over the place. We see that they're into appliances. Again, insurance company, the pet insurance company. Notice that, by the way, that, I don't know if you remember, but those are different insurance companies. And they're, see what else they like, you know.
Right.
They like
the big takeaway is you're looking for the most, I don't know if this is the word is plebeian, the most mundane product that nobody in the right, it's not an aspirational product, right? It's not like Rolex or Ferrari, right? Which is not indicative
right.
of whether or not someone's but the key is the most boring, I'm going to swear, the most boring fucking product that you can find, that the only way someone's going to actually use the damn thing is if they like the thing, is if they're using the thing. Right?
I'm supposed to be the controversial one, not you.
No, but I'm saying, I'm not putting that I like Alpo on my Facebook wall to show off to my friends on, look at me, right? I'm using it because my dog eats Alpo.
Now, if you remember, guys, and Ryan anticipated where I was going with here, is if you remember when I did the premium dog foods, we're talking about a totally different demographic.
Mm.
Okay, here they're 43% spenders. That's because right. they don't have the money. They don't have credit. And you see here that a much smaller number is over this. So if you want to sell to these people, you need to keep in mind that the dog demographic is not one huge monolithic demographic. You need to know your audience. And someone asked a question like, how do I know what to do? Because I sit here and I play for hours on with Facebook custom audiences, drilling down to determine. And then when I ultimately do that, my targeting is just incredible. Okay? So that's why I consider myself like a full-time Facebook geek, because I will sit in here and I will build audiences, and then I will target those audiences so precisely that I do really well. So let's come back to our presentation and move on a little bit now that we've seen. Now, what I'm about to tell you is going to frighten you a little bit, but it's absolutely true. And if it helps save even one person's Facebook account, then I'm happy. So here's what Facebook hates. I feel like the J.R. Tolkien in The Hobbit when they sing, that's what Bilbo Baggins hates. Well, this is what Facebook hates. In the weight loss niche, they do not like sexy pictures, and they do not like before and after pictures, okay? If you use this, they may just disapprove the ad. If they disapprove a lot of your ads, you're going to lose your ad account. So sexy pictures, before or after, forget it. Dating, unless it's an established site like eHarmony, Facebook really does not want to see dating stuff. The reason for these things is because, unfortunately, some of our brethren in the marketing niche have totally abused these things, and Facebook wants to protect their user experience. Network marketing, Facebook doesn't want to hear about it. Work-at-home schemes, Facebook doesn't want to hear about it. Make money online, Facebook doesn't want to hear about it. However, if you are making specific claims for just about anything, Facebook will first send you some warning notices, and then ultimately they will close your account. Now, what I showed you can save you because targeting matters. Now, there are people... There's a client of mine, God bless him, he's in the weight loss, and he's targeting people who like Oprah magazine, assuming that because they like Oprah magazine, they must be fat. And he's showing them weight loss ads, and now Facebook allows you to like say, I don't want to see these ads, and when they do, enough of those objections, and Facebook shuts your account. And let me tell you, Facebook pays a lot of attention to this. So if you target the wrong people, not only are you losing money, but you're playing Russian roulette with your account.
Right. Even if, I think the important thing on that, Harlan, is even if you're not doing any of the above, you could have the most innocent, you know, how would you like a sweater for your dog for Christmas, but you're sending that to, God, people who hate dogs or cat owners or something
exactly.
like that.
Exactly. This is a huge takeaway. Your targeting counts. Now, for example, in the marketing world, and there may be a few marketers on here, everyone is looping everything they're targeting at the same time. Frank Kern, Tony Robbins, people who like Frank Kern, people like Tony Robbins, people who like Marie Forleo, Brendan Burchard, and you know what? All of these are different audiences. My good friend Ryan spends all of his time learning how to talk to different audiences. Okay? We've spent hours learning the exact thing to say to my dog audience to make sure that it works the first time. But when you take everybody, imagine how many different private clients do you have, Brian?
I'm in 23 different markets right now.
Okay. Can you imagine sending a message that would be appealing to all 23 different markets that would work for everyone?
No.
Wouldn't you think you might get some objections?
Even the languaging, even the level of profanity, even the level of contractions and formality of the language, you have to be extremely malleable in terms of the way that you speak to different audiences. And this is not only true across markets, but as I'm sure you appreciate more than anybody else, within these large mass markets like dog owners, it's the same thing. The way you speak to the woman who buys the 19-cent cat food at the dollar store is very different than the woman who mail orders the $3 a can organic grass-fed stuff shipped straight from Alaska.
Exactly. And this is another huge takeaway. When you are building an ad campaign, build your ad campaigns really tight, target one group, and go in there and do Facebook audience insights to understand who they are, what are they reading, how do they talk, what's on their mind, and you will do a lot better. Now, here's a new rule that hasn't even been talked about. Yesterday, we talked about that page, and play nice from Ryan, because I said that their landing page was illegal. The new rule from Facebook is that your landing page must also be compliant with Facebook's terms of service. So this landing page, which has before and after pictures, is not compliant in Facebook's terms.
There's so much. I mean, there are nuances that, you know, and I know we won't have time to get into everything, kind of being mindful of the time here, but there are certain things that we've learned. Like, I'll give you a very specific example. Facebook does not like speaking about isolated body improvement. So specifically saying this is going to target underarm flab, this is going to target belly flab, this is going to target cottage cheese cellulite underneath your thighs. Targeted, isolated body enhancement or improvement, whether that's through muscle building, fat loss, what have you, done like it. So there are a lot of nuances here, and I know that's one of the things that you are probably better versed in than most people, just based on the amount of time and the importance of Facebook in your business.
So what I'm so happy about is that I have an audience of people who are going to take this and do it, make more money, and also not cross any of Facebook's red lines. Okay? Now, we talked about surveys. Here's a perfectly legal survey. It gets 85% opt-in rates. The one that I showed you before, 59% opt-in rates. Why am I showing you a survey now? Let me connect it. Facebook says that you can bring people to surveys. I take them through the survey. People have a very high percent of following these surveys. When they get to the end of the survey, I can show them all the before and after pictures I want, and it will be perfectly legal. It will be compliant with Facebook's terms of service, and it will get the opt-in. But just don't break Facebook's rules. You heard it here first. So survey, make your survey clean. People will opt in if you use the right copy on your survey. You'll get the email opt-in, and you will be able to use all the good stuff that you want to say, like get rid of those cottage cheese thighs, but not on the first page. How's that for a takeaway?
Guys, this is freaking huge. I mean, you know, hopefully, if you don't recognize the value in this right here, I mean, this is like $1 million secret. The $1 million secret is you find whatever mechanism you can, which in this case is a survey, one of multiple potential avenues, a survey, which is a variation on the methodology that I teach, but this is just as effective and use variations on this in markets as well. This methodology to get people into your world, which buys you the ability to deliver the true message that you want to deliver, which is going to pack that sales punch. You just have to introduce this intermediate step in between, and you want to make sure that you're not disqualifying the wrong people, that you are attracting the same people that you want to attract who are ultimately going to be buyers.
So this is stuff that you could take away to the bank. Now, here's our problem. Facebook lets you build lists, and I ask in the immortal words of The Who, now who the hell are you? Because when you build those lists and those lookalike audiences, people don't really know who you are. They don't know that Ryan is this freaking genius who has the abilities to analyze a market and get so far up into the head of the people that Ryan can actually scratch their heads for them. These people don't know Ryan. The people on these lists don't particularly like you because they don't know you. You have nothing in common with you when you have Facebook build a list for you. The people on this list don't trust you. It's like, yeah, sure. Now, if you have enough money to test with, eventually you'll get it right. But everybody needs some secret sauce. And my secret sauce is give people something really valuable and they will drive traffic to your door. And that's what I do is I give people viral reports. I give people content that is so good for what they want, for what they're interested in, whether it's golf or whether it's meditation or whether it's dogs. You have to find out what those issues are. And let me tell you, you use that and your list will grow. How will your list grow? Well, this is how my list grew with a viral report. As of 8 a.m. today, my list totaled 738,100 since July 1st. Now, Ryan, when we talked last week, I was still in the 600,000s.
What's amazing about your approach, and I don't want to steal your thunder, is for any of the math geeks here, it's an exponential growth path. It's a hockey stick growth path where if you've ever – I mean, that's amazing. That's A, that's freaking amazing. But B, I wouldn't be surprised when we talk next week that number would be starting with an 8.
Again, and the bottom line here is not – I'm not just collecting a list for the sake of a list. I'm making money on this. Since July 1st, I've made 432,000 traceable to this particular list. It's a hybrid list of Facebook and email. And people want to give me more. And this is just getting started. So I've taught this program that I have. It's called the immediate list method. And actually, somebody who joined the program, I knew him. I had actually bought his product. He's a trainer, and he's online. And by week number 3, he posted in my Facebook group saying, Harlan, I just made an extra 100,000. And I said, just 100,000? And he said, hey, Harlan, it's only week 3. You know, let me get to week 6. I'll double it. And what happens is, when you build this list of people that know you, there are people that know you, that people that trust you, and they are ready to buy from you. So it's not, you don't need me to go to Facebook and create a lookalike audience of 2 million people. But I'll take that audience of millions and millions of people and show a viral list that grows and grows and grows. Now, incidentally, I showed this method to Facebook, and Facebook looked at it and they said, you know, Harlan, this is pretty good, but if I were you, I would do this, 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 and this, and they made it even better. So this technique is absolutely Facebook approved. They're actually coaching me on it because they just like the way it works. My course is 6 weeks. And week number one, we give you an overview. We explain how it works. We do an assessment of your situation. We see exactly what your individual needs are, and you'll be given homework to prepare for week number two. And week number two, we do targeting. And targeting is where we take what we did today as the starting point and go deeper, okay? And we actually start building your list on the call. People who are in the program with me are told, make sure you have a headset mic, because during the webinar, I'm going to be unmuting you, and we're going to be chatting and working together. You'll be watching my screen, and I'll be building your list with you. And week number two, you're just going to become an expert in audience insights. Week number three, this is where things start to get insane. It's the bounce back technique. It's the viral core, and this is where you start building your viral list. There is not a single person who has gone through week number three and then at the end just went, you are so geeky awesome. I mean, when you understand the heart of the technique, I show it to you in week number one, but when we get to week number three and we go into the detail and you see the viral reports and how they work, and you see the whole evil, dark plan, where it really starts to happen. This is the way my list grows. It's 2,500 to 5,000 every day. I don't do anything. Week number four, we set the mechanisms up for creating your hot list. What does your list need to raise their hands? This was an ad that I used, and the only reason I show it is up at the top you see that this was dated July 1st. That was the day that I started my list building, and now it's over 700,000. Week number five, drip, drip, drip. Get that list, start building the trust, building the familiarity, so that they're going to buy from you. And week number six is, I want you to start cashing in on the list. God bless my good friend Dean, but I don't want to wait that long. And incidentally, again, I consider Dean one of the smartest guys on the internet, but he sent one of his closest students to my house last week to sit with me for hours and show them how to institute this so they could put it to work in their business. My hybrid list of Facebook and email has made me over six figures in just the past week. Okay? I just launched a new program, and the most amazing thing about this program is that the majority of the people in the program are people who have never bought anything from me, and I did a search, they are in none of my other lists. It came about through this method. In very rapid time, they determine, and they're from all over, I've never heard of these people before, and they're in there and gave me money. So I know that this works, and plus, I do this for myself. It's time for you to get angry, and many people are going to get angry, and I apologize, and I hope that you got the content will assuage some of you the anger. But what I've learned in marketing is that the 80-20 rule absolutely works, is that 20 people out of the 100, 20 people are going to work, and 80% won't do anything. Well, I'd rather work with the 20 and not the 80. Don't take it personally, but I really only want to work with the people who are highly motivated, who will get their results. The 20 I work with will run silent, run deep with their results. My clients typically make hundreds of millions of dollars, just like Ryan's clients dominate industries. My clients are silently making $30,000, $40,000, $50,000 a day, and nobody even knows what they do. Plus, I don't want to deal with last day refunders, people who are going to come into the program and calculate, okay, if there's a 22-day, day 22, okay, I'm done. You know what? Do us both a favor. I'd rather not have people purchase who are going to refund to begin with. I want people who are fully committed to learning the method and building the list. In short, I like to work with extremely dedicated, action-oriented people, and I will over-deliver. But you're not going to be happy because you don't purchase a Tesla at Mini Cooper prices, okay? People call this a smart car. Maybe not. It may be smart on gas mileage. It's not real smart if you get into a crash. So prepare for sticker shock, because Ryan told me that his list had never paid for an offer this expensive. And I said, suck it up, girly. Well, that's not exactly what I said, but I went, okay. I'm cutting my prices for the webinar because I charge by the value. What's the value of a course that can increase your income by 60 to 240K or more in the next 12 months? Okay. Some of the people are going to be hoping for, you know, a $7 warrior special offer. I don't do business this way. The bonus that I'm going to share with people who come aboard will make me at least six figures in the next year. My bonus, and Ryan actually pulled this out of me, is something that's called the Small Sites Big Money Program. Now, I'm doing a program with Ryan, and I'm estimating that there are tens of thousands of costs involved in the startup. Well, I already have a company that is going to underwrite the whole thing. Ryan, I should have added your fees to the price, but I was done. A couple of people have seen this program, Small Sites, Big Money, and one of them is Keith Baxter. I know you know Keith. Here's what Keith had to say. Harlan setting the bar by once again defining what potential really exists within authority sites. The evolution of the Doggington Post and the new initiatives underway on that site. He's combined curated content and community in a way that very few marketers have been able to successfully accomplish. But even beyond that, he's able to teach what, why, and how he did it in an understandable way. Kudos, Harlan, Keith Baxter. This one's really hard to read. The testimonial was so small, but this was a guy who had already been experimenting with the stuff that I had and decided to accept, instead of AdSense or CPM banners, he came up with an idea, and he was offered $600 to write a couple of sentences about a product. Then he saw my webinar, and he said, so I know what you taught works, but I wanted to learn how to take this to the next level and add a few more zeros to my bottom line. Now you know. And you said it clearly. Go after companies with deep pockets and take their money. And that's what I'm doing. So God willing, that one piece of information I learned from you will help me turn on an additional five figures for my site by the year is out. And this, folks, is just the bonus. So here's what you get. You get 6 weeks of live webinars with me. You get lots of individual attention. Make sure you have a microphone, as I said, because I'll be calling on you and we'll be chatting live. Help at every step of the way. There's a private Facebook group, and you'll also get the bonus, my Small Sites Big Money program, where you can get big companies to sponsor your site and actually give you substantial amounts of money. Now, before I put the link up, I want to tell you something that I don't usually offer this on a webinar. I offer this only to people on my Facebook page, and I teach this only in small groups. When you go over to the sales page, for those of you who want to continue your studies with me, you're going to see that it's limited only to 10. In truth, God bless him, but my graphic designer made that a graphic, so I can't change it. I have no idea how many people are going to join. I know that I'm going to get a lot of sharp marketers, and that's my goal. I've been getting Facebook messages the whole time this has been going, from people who are on the call going, Harlan, I want the link. Harlan, I want the link. So it says limited to 10. It's not limited to 10. Okay, you grow the humongous list. This is the place to go. It's the instantlistmethod.com/survey, because Ryan is the survey guy. You can join today for one payment of $3,000. You can join today for three payments of $1,200, or you could join today for six payments of $700. And I'm going to take a deep breath, and Ryan, if you have questions, I'm going to answer them.
Yeah, man. I mean, listen, first of all, awesome webinar. I walked away. It's rare that I will go through a webinar that is not part of a paid training program. That is really a webinar that, let's be honest here, we're all friends, that's designed to sell a program and walk away with as many actionable ideas and tips. So first of all, I want to say thank you for that, because I know you promised me that you were going to teach, and I said, if we do this, I have one condition, it's that people are going to walk away with tremendous value. So I 100% think you over-delivered on that, and I'd like, you know, everybody in the chat to, first of all, just a great big thank you to Harlan for taking time to do this. That's the first thing. Second thing is, the chat is literally lighting up right now with questions, and if it's okay with you, what I'd like to do is maybe start going through some of those questions, and anybody who does have a question, I'll be perfectly honest, I have a hard stop in 15 minutes. I have a client call. I need to wrap at that time. So first things first, we've put the link in the chat. If you haven't seen it already, you just click on that, make sure it's working. I'm doing that right now myself. Looks like the link is working. If you have any issues, please let me know. And then, Harlan, what I'd like to do is kind of just go through the questions one by one. Vernon says, thank you. Marcel says, let's put this webinar is great. Let's put it like this, the webinar is awesome. Okay, so here are some of the questions that have been coming through. A lot of people saying that Mikey saying thank you, Anna saying thank you, amazing. Targeting info is awesome, as Alex is saying. Awesome. Great webinar. Thanks. A lot of great feedback. All right, let's go through some of the questions that people are asking. So people are saying, is it okay, let's get right to the elephant in the room. So this is a lot of money compared to some things that other people have seen before. Is it worth it? And how would you answer that question? I know my answer to that question, but how would you answer that question?
Well, my answer to that question is that's up to them. If building a highly targeted list, you know, the number one thing, I know that Frank Kern stood on a stage in Las Vegas a number of years ago and just said by show of hands how many people have a list, and something like 10% of the room put their hands up.
Mm-hmm.
A list, you guys know, we've said it, the money's in the list.
Yep.
If you do not have a targeted list, then there's the immediate value, is being able to get a highly targeted list. However, my best customers learn that, number one, anybody can do this. You do not have to be a Facebook wizard. I will turn you into one. Next, that I want you to have in mind something that you would like to sell. Okay? The more high ticket item you have, the better it is. If you can come up with products that have value to them, you can make money very, very quickly. You can succeed right out of the gate the first time if you can follow instructions. If you could follow my webinar today, then you will be able to follow it. As a matter of fact, I hand you a flow chart in session number one, and then we go through it over the course, and we blow up the flow chart so you know exactly what to do. If you are the person who can just fill in the dots, it's for you. You, that's something that you have to judge.
Mm-hmm. And the way, listen, the way I would answer this question, that question is this, is like this. I can burn through $3,000 in advertising spend on Facebook like it's my job, right? You can burn through that kind of money really fast and still not have something work. Money buys speed. You can easily spend $10,000, $15,000, $20,000 in Facebook before you have something that works. I see it all day, every day. The reason why clients pay me the kind of money that they pay me, and I have clients who have come up to me, and there might be some on this call right now who have said, Ryan, I tried to implement your stuff on my own, and 6 months later, still haven't been able to crack the nut. So I'm going to suck it up and pay you. And those are the clients that end up hitting home runs. I even have clients now that they start in a consulting relationship, and they say they're going to do the lowest ticket option that they might have, and they say, you know what, I'm just going to have you do the whole thing. Cost me more money, but I'd rather have this thing working now than 18 months from now to be spinning my wheels in the same place that I'm in right now. Money buys speed. And the reason why this is priced the way it is because I've seen it and I am implementing. I'm not talking about it yet because I'm kind of keeping it close to the vest. I'm implementing exactly what Harlan's doing because I've seen what he's done in his other markets. It is unlike anything I've ever seen. You have to remember, I have access to virtually every Facebook expert really on the planet. All the top dogs, I have access to them. I can pick up the phone and I can talk to someone like Kurt Malley and I can say, hey, what will you do in this exact situation? And there's another dozen experts like this. So I know what everybody is doing. This is different. This is unlike anything that I'd ever seen until Harlan showed it to me and I saw what it was doing. So that's number one. Harlan, a question that people are asking in terms of investment. What type of ad budget might someone want to expect above and beyond on the training itself as they're thinking about, you know, is there a place for this in my business?
$200 to $300, and if you're going to be quick, you're going to make it back by you're going to make your investment back by the end of the course. Now, again, I can only say that for people who are take action people. If you're not a take action person, just take the knowledge I gave you, thank me, and go on. I honestly would prefer that you not do it. Also, if you are the kind of person who is not going to, it's a decision between your family eating and you joining, I would also prefer that you not join. I'm looking for I'm looking for people who are serious business people and can recognize the value, but let not your experience on Facebook hold you back.
Cool. Questions coming in about seeing the whole process in week one. Questions coming from a more advanced marketer, someone who's deep in, front-end PPC. They'd like to be able to be off to the races right away. What would you say to someone who, wants to get everything all at once to kind of kick things off and hit it hard?
So we had we've had people do that before. Keith Baxter, as a matter of fact, wanted to do that, and I like Keith, but he ran ahead and then he came back and he went, well, I made some changes. I think I'm going to come back and follow the system. So I have no problem about letting people go ahead. I can private message them, a different series. You saw an older series of webinars.
Right.
But if someone's chopping at the bit and, they're a good marketer, and I'm reasonable, I'll be very happy to let them go ahead.
Sure. Someone asked a question, is Ryan requisite? The answer to that is no. Harlan's one of these people that approached me having come from a background of using surveys. And so he's someone who's in the category of recognizing that hiring the right person, working with the right person who's been there, done that, is a much, you know, the opportunity cost is tremendous, right? And for someone who's considering trying to build a massive list through Facebook, the opportunity cost, in many cases for most of us, is far higher than the $3,000 asking price to get access to this. Again, ask yourself, if you could spin your wheels for the next 6 months and do it on your own, or if you could get the whole blueprint handed to you on a silver platter tomorrow, and that would cost you $3,000, what's more valuable to you, the $3,000 or 6 months of your life? And for some people, the answer is 6 months of my life, and that's fine, and that just means it's not a good fit. You probably would be not a good fit going through the program. But if you ask yourself that question and you say, well, I would much rather be ahead knowing the type of money I could be making in that 6 months, then this really is a no-brainer. One thing I do want to clarify, Harlan, you mentioned about the bonus, and I just want to make sure that you and I are on the same page. That bonus, if I'm not mistaken, that's a bonus that's only available if you are a Next Level Mastermind member. Is that correct? The one that we discussed?
Well, you are jogging my memory, and so I did not say that, but I will come up with an additional bonus. I will discuss it with you tomorrow.
Okay.
I will come up with an additional bonus for Next Level Mastermind people.
Got it. Okay.
I'll send you the list, and I will give them an additional bonus that will be well worth their
awesome
investment.
So the thing that you're talking about is how to fund your survey if you're doing this from scratch, correct?
Well, actually, it's really more when you have a list and you have a site and you want to do something awesome, how to get someone else to pay for it.
Got it. So it's more broad. I don't want to give away the secret here, but for anybody who said, I'm starting from ground zero, I have no funds, I have no audience, how can I come up with the money to get all the data that I need to either do Harlan's methodology or the survey funnel methodology that I teach, and how do I pay for my traffic? Harlan came up with something that I'm kicking myself in the head for not having figured this out or come up with it about 5 years ago, whereby any time I go into a new market now, I have a method to get, what, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60K to fund the whole thing from the beginning, so that it requires zero capital cash outlay on my part to buy the traffic, to send that traffic to the survey, to buy that traffic, to send it to the initial customer acquisition path, the whole in a way that's a win-win that I am absolutely kicking myself that I didn't think about this 5 years ago, because it's a game changer. It truly is. And it's at the point now where I have Harlan consulting with my other clients to do the same thing as an add-on to what we already do. That bonus alone is, I mean, it's really worth the price of what you're asking for the program. So I think that's really brilliant. Let's see. I'm going through some of the questions. One person says, I'm an affiliate, I'm not a product owner. This question came up a couple times. I sell products in the 10 to 15K range. Would this be a good way to promote them?
Yes.
Does this work for a big market, or do I need to be in a big market, or can it work for more quote-unquote niche markets?
Can work for niche markets as well.
Question Jay is asking, does this come with the survey software we need to use? And this question has come up a few times. It was in question to the types of surveys that you showed, the millionaire quiz and the fat loss quiz, that type of survey. Is it, I guess the two questions are, A, is it predicated on using a page that looks like that? And if so, do we have specific software that we would be using to generate those particular pages?
Well, if I'm going to go through with Ryan, but if you're in this was going to be my bonus for the Next Level Mastermind people who are not using Ryan software.
Okay. Awesome. So anybody who's a Next Level Mastermind member will get access to that software, your software that you use to build those surveys. And to be clear, if you're not a Mastermind member and you want to get access to that bonus, then you can, as long as you sign up before then, I've asked Harlan to honor that for you. I'm just going through the questions one by one in the last 3 minutes that we have here. What would kind of the schedule be for the live webinar training? If you can just roughly walk that through.
We'll start next week. It depends when I know you're going to show this for a replay, mm-hmm. but we'll start next week, and then we'll find a time and a date, and we stick to it for the next 6 weeks.
Awesome. So, guys, if you're wondering about the deadline,
if possible, we might skip Christmas week. People may want off and right. come back, but I'll toss that up to the group.
Yeah, so this is going to be very simple. The deadline to take advantage of this is going to be this Sunday at 11:59 Pacific time. This Sunday, for anybody who wants to write this down in your calendar, is 23rd of November. The reason for that is very simple. Next week is Thanksgiving week. It's a short week. Harlan, to get this going in time for the holiday season, needs to kick off the live training. And Thursday and perhaps Friday are probably out with Thanksgiving. So anybody who's going to be part of this program needs to get in no later than this Sunday, 11:59. Going through this, is this for any niche or only dogs? It's for any niche. What's the big promise? Build a list economically fast way, faster than other methods. Harlan, if you want to speak to that.
The big promise is you're going to be able to build a highly targeted list in record time, even if you've never had a list in your life.
Mm-hmm. Cool, going through this. Is it possible to build a dating list, given you said Facebook won't let you run dating ads unless it's eHarmony?
I would advise you strongly against that. Mm. It's not a fit.
Got it.
You can build the list, but you could definitely build the list. That's A. B is you would definitely have to use a survey and a very roundabout method to use it, because I won't advise otherwise. If
right.
you bring if you bring people to a survey of like, you know, take the kissable, are you kissable, and you make a fun quiz out of it and it says nothing about dating, it's really likely that Facebook would let that go.
I've gotten this question before, and I tell it because I'm successfully doing this with a client, so I have to be careful. But you just have to ask yourself, what topics of interest do single people who are interested in dating also have? Okay, and how do you, in your language, build that list in a roundabout way? Can it be done? Yes. Can you ask people directly, what kind of men are you interested in? No. When does it start? I'm in Australia. I'll be happy to get up at 2 a.m. if needed. I think you'll work out the details on the timing. I imagine you'll have recordings for people. One question was, if I already have a program, do I need this? Is this a fit?
If you're in 6 and 6, I would not take advantage of this. I would pass. You won't need it. Hey, I love business, but I love honesty more.
Sure. Listen, Harlan, this is awesome. I'm 2 minutes past the hour. I'm going to run to this call. I super appreciate your time. If all things work out, fingers crossed, this replay will be saved, and we'll make the replay available. If you came on to the call late, if there's anything that you want to catch, the offer to get in this opportunity for the live training that Harlan's going to be starting next week, where he's going to walk you through his viral list building methodology using viral reports. And by the way, it's the key here is the unique way in which you are building a hybrid list. Okay, you have to ask yourself, with everything that Harlan walked through on the limitations of email, the declining open rates, declining click-through rates, increase in spam complaints, increase in unsubscribes, emails that simply don't get delivered, having access to both Facebook and email as a way to market to your list in conjunction with one another, and building that list in a way that's scalable economically through the virality of the reports. So in other words, instead of having to pay for each individual subscriber, every subscriber that you pay for generates three more subscribers for free, which then each generate an additional three more subscribers for free. That is the secret. It's the hybrid list plus the virality of building that list and the math that goes around with it, and the fact that Harlan's probably going to have 800,000 people on his list by the time he and I talk next week. That is the magic. It's this thing that creates this self-perpetual process that grows and grows and grows. So I'm implementing it. When I was able to convince Harlan to make this available at a price that, to be perfectly honest, he could easily say, I'm going to work with 10 private clients. I'm going to charge you $50,000 a year each. I'm not sure why Harlan's not doing that, because he might be able to make more money doing that. I also know the way Harlan works. I know I've met students of Harlan, Titans of Direct Response. I met some of his students, and I know that there is this dichotomy between Harlan's public persona and people who have worked with him privately. He's one of the most generous people you've ever met. I think one time he sent me, 60, 70 mind maps of all these talks that you've been to, just because you know that I'm a geek about copywriting and different persuasion architectures and so on and so forth, and you just kept sending me. So this is stuff that you could have sold for thousands of dollars, and you just gifted it to me. So I know some things privately about Harlan that why he is the way he is, and someone asked in the chat, why is he selling it for so cheap? Harlan doesn't need the money. I think, Harlan's at a point in his life and in his career where, making money is still important, especially from the standpoint of he wants people to value the information that they're getting access to. But, he's a guy that over-delivers, and I've seen that firsthand. So anybody considering this opportunity, if you're interested in Facebook growing your list, I give it my absolute highest endorsement. Again, you know that I'm very selective in the opportunities and programs that I recommend. It's really limited to things that I'm using personally myself and things that I'm working on implementing myself, and this is in the former category. So, Harlan, thank you again, my man. I super appreciate your time, and we'll be talking tomorrow afternoon on some dog stuff.
Fantastic. Thanks, everybody. Thanks, honoring me with your presence, and all good. Look forward to seeing a bunch of you on the inside. Take care, everybody.
Awesome. Thanks, guys.